then of course Karjakin should analyze why Carson was thinking for so long and made normal move. And instead Karjakin made immediately reply, which was lost. And at the time he had peace sacrifice and perpetual check. And so he would lead 1 point ahead before the last game. So I think Carson had winning match, but he missed, and then he is under the pressure of that result till now. Already many years passed, but still Karjakin cannot get back because I think he has psychological problems, always remembering missing opportunity to become world champion in 2 games. Okay.
You travel a lot all around the world these days, yeah, for chess. How many days in a year on the road? 100? 200?
I don't have this possibilities now because I'm a member of parliament, and so except for summer, I must stay 3 weeks a month in Moscow. Yes. But I use sometimes Friday, Saturday, Sunday. In the middle of the week I have to be in Moscow, and we have scheduled 3 weeks in Moscow in parliament and one week in the region from where we were elected. And because I'm working hard and so I can do my program quicker, so this week is possible for travel, because instead of 5 days working days I stay 2-3 days. I'm working from 11 till 7-8, and then I can use other days for my chess activity out of the country. But now end of July was very busy, and August probably one of the busiest period of time, and so the idea to visit Helsinki came quite late, and so just a big fortune that we could find 1.5 days, because I was in Spain, then I was in Ural. Actually, most probably next year we should have candidates tournament in Yekaterinburg, the main city of Ural, and we just formed our offer and request. I hope that we shall win. And I'm there very active. I was born in Ural, not in Yekaterinburg. I was born in South Ural, but I'm helping to develop chess in Yekaterinburg. And I saw the facilities. I think if we get this opportunity, so it will be the best site for many years, probably the best site for the whole history of candidates matches or candidates team, because we have new Palace of Congress in Yekaterinburg. If we have visitors enough, it will be hall for 4,000 people, and beautiful, modern, better than Kremlin Palace. And if you don't have visitors enough, then it will be reserved hall for, I think, 1,000 visitors, spectators, and then of course all modern facilities. So this is like this. So the 30th of July I was there. Then I was in I was in Italy. I have for the fourth year summer chess school or chess session in Sardinia, and then I traveled. It's difficult to remember.
So a lot is obvious.
No, I was in Montenegro. Yes. What? Montenegro and Bosnia and Herzegovina. I was there for 3 days, and I had negotiations, and most probably we shall start chess education in these countries locally, and then we shall take the whole country, and I will open two schools, Karpatcha schools in Montenegro and in Bosnia and Herzegovina. And then I signed the agreement with Turkey. It will be educational, Karpov educational center to prepare teachers for the schools in Turkey. And so they want to have a federal program, Chechen school. And actually they are quite advanced in this. And then last days I was in Siberia, in Kemerovo. We had big chess event. They celebrate 300 years of Kuzbass. Probably you know, this is one of the most important industrial province in the world. And so they celebrate 300 years. And so they made a chess event with 600 players, young players. So 600 kids, boys and girls, were playing. And then again I was at Ekaterinburg, and then I came back, and then I went to France, then here. Tomorrow I fly to Minsk, Belarus, and then from Minsk I go to close my summer session in Sardinia, and after this I come back to Siberia. So the 30th of August I should be in Tumen. And so here, then Moscow, Minsk, Sardinia, Moscow and Tumen in the next 6 days.
Quite a fantastic tour, really.
Yeah.
Shall we take the next game?
No, probably we continue like this, or do we have time for next?
Yes, we have business.
Okay, let's. So, Karpov Spassky, as I said, e4, c5.
Sorry,
c4? 74.
74, yes.
So this was quite difficult psychological match, because Spassky was my hero in the young age. So he was world champion for not a long time, but he was very very attractive. And I learned a lot from him. And it was just after his match against Fischer. And that time I had not too much experience in world championships, and so I said that moment in 73 when I won the interzonal tournament, I said that this is not my cycle, probably another time I can become world champion. But I prepared very hard for the match with Spassky, and so I could get fantastic advantage in this match. I won 4-1 in 11 games, which is even better than Fischer. Fischer won match against Spassky with the advantage of 4 points in 21 games. I got 3 points in 11 games. The percentage is much higher. So, okay, this one, c5, knight f3, d6, or d6. Yes. So, take. Knight f6, c3, d6. So usually I play the Keres attack, g4. Actually this is also possible, but in match with Spassky I decided to play classical way, bishop e2. So bishop e7, castle. f4. Knight d6, bishop d7, knight d3, and then he surprised me in the first game of that match with move a5. And so I played not so bad that game, but it was good lesson for me. Because we played that match in St. Petersburg, that time Leningrad. And so I went to finish golf, to for skating, and then I got sick. I got high fever, and then I called the organizer. I said I cannot go to for the opening, we must postpone. And then organizers, and I was living, I was student of Leningrad University. And so organizers knew me quite well, I knew them, and then they said, but we sent all the invitations, and so could you just come for the opening ceremony, even if you're ill? And then, after we postponed the first game, I didn't know rules very well, and I accepted this. So we opened the match, and then still I had fever of 38, and I played that game with 38. And I had to play because the chief arbiter, after the opening ceremony, I said, I want to postpone the first game. He said, if you postpone the first game, you will lose the match. The first game cannot be postponed. And so I had to play ill that game. And then at the end, of course, I couldn't keep concentration for a long time, and then I made mistake on the third, the fourth hour of play. But here I was prepared already. So a4, knight b4. Of course, we control b5 square for the whole game probably, but then it's difficult to control b5 and to stop activity on in the center. Because the position of black pieces and black pawns are quite has harmony. So knight b4, then knight b4, or bishop c6. Bishop f3, bishop c6, knight d4. g6. So e5 is not possible immediately because knight on f5, and Spassky is preparing e5. So white knight cannot jump to f5. g6, then rook f2. Important to be able to bring rook to d2 and also to protect pawn on c2. e5. Knight takes c6. B takes c6. F takes e5. Pawn takes e5. Yeah. And so now c6 pawn covers g5 and d5, and then theoretically white color bishop is not so promising, because e4 pawn we should block with e5, and then if black would be able to exchange black color bishops, probably they have even better position. But the problem how to do this. So rook f2. Rook f2, yeah? Or queen?
Queen f1.
Queen f1, yes. Yes. So this is very important, because if I would play rook d2, then queen c8, and then queen comes to e6, and I cannot control this. And c4 is a key strategical square in the game. So that's why queen f1. And so now you play with queen c8 and queen c4. Or h3, just like that.
The queen c8, h3.
H3,
yes.
Then if king goes to e6, then we play. What do we play?
It wasn't the game.
Huh? No, it wasn't the game.
Not 97.
97, because if queen e6, then simply we play rook c1, and then bishop e2, and bishop comes to c4. And the knight d7 is not possible here because of rook bishop g4. And so that's why, and if knight doesn't go to d7, then we play bishop e2 and bishop c4. And we attack f7, which is quite weak in the position. So, Spassky played the knight to bishop. And then he wants to exchange bishops, what I said. So bishop g4 is the only way to stop it, because if we play its idea. Then black can play even bishop h4. And then you have to play rook with d2 on e2. And black has plenty of time to create something. Or even black can play bishop e4, kill the threat, yeah? Or maybe queen c7. And then knight e6, bishop c5. So this is the main idea. Bishop e4, h5, bishop takes, queen takes. And so what we can see now, when we exchange one knight, the knight on b4 is not so dangerous for white. This alone. So queen c4, we can draw b6. And of course after queen e6 we simply exchange and then we have extra pawn. Double pawn c5 b6. And I cannot claim this is winning position, but it's a big advantage and this is one side game. So Spassky played bishop h4, rook d2, queen goes to e7, yes, rook to f1, and then rook d8, then this is the most attractive move. I played, it was very difficult to find it. But this is a beautiful move because positionally this is fantastic. First of all, still we want to be able to kick out this line. And we can do it only with one pawn c2. And then our knight is not so active. And of course,